Welcome back to Staha 92. My name is Adam, and today I'm going to be walking you through how to make your very own Twitch emote in its simplest form, so you don't have to go pay some professional artist to draw you a cartoon for a lot of money. Why am I doing this for free? Oh, hey, it's early in the video. I've got your attention. Why not just plug all my shit right now? Staha92 on all socials. If you'd like, you could just go ahead and sub to the YouTube channel. Even leave a thumbs up. And something about a bell. Okay, let's get started. So, I'm going to be walking you through a time-lapse video of the Twitch emote that I made, which is Raiden from the Mortal Kombat video game series. And the movie's coming out soon, so I'm really excited. Keep in mind, before you get going, if you want to consider this your first step, have a plan. Have some general idea of what you're going to be creating. I can't tell you how often I just stare at a blank canvas, not really knowing what I want to do. So I created this particular Twitch emote out of Procreate on my iPad Pro, but do you really need to make it out of Procreate? No, not at all. I don't think so. Just use whatever you want to use. I think as long as you have access to layers, you'll be good to go. Okay, canvas size. The size of the canvas that I typically use is 1,000 pixels by 1,000 pixels. I used to do 750 by 750 pixels. Use whatever you want. You don't need to make it too big. Just make sure it's squared. Okay, you got your canvas set. The next step is the most important part of the entire process. This is where you're going to sketch out a rough draft. Yep, that's the most important part. The rough draft. I mean, that's pretty much what artwork is already. The whole process is just a rough draft until you finally say, this is the final draft. If you are working out of Procreate and you're curious of which brush that I used, I went into the brush library, I went down to painting, and I used the round brush. Now, I clicked on the round brush once, and I set the streamline down to zero because I think that's kind of odd when you're doing a freehand sketch. And then I went and set the opacity at about 45% and the brush size, you know, 7 or 8 or whatever you feel comfortable with. But you can use whatever brush that you'd like for this face. I want you to create as many layers as you need. Just rough draft on top of rough draft on top of rough draft, because eventually you're going to add a little bit more detail each time, getting you a lot closer to that base model.
Take your time and work at your own pace. Speed will come with practice.
And then we're going to go in and we're going to add the line work in, and then we're going to add some color and then shadows if you'd like. Okay, now you should be getting pretty comfortable with the skeleton that you have formed. Let's go on to the next layer, which is going to be another rough draft, but now it's going to be based around line work. So what I used was the calligraphy pen. I used the script pen that's at the very bottom. If it's just like basic Procreate, I went ahead and set the opacity to 100%. I added a little bit of the streamline effect because at this point, I think it helps with the flow of the line. The calligraphy, for the sake of it, presents some cool edges. But you can use, once again, whatever pen that you'd like to use. In terms of the brush size, just think about, you know, some sort of thickness or width that's going to look good in the long run. You don't want it to be too thin, because when you shrink this bad boy down, you actually want those lines to pop a little bit to stand out against the chat. Now that's more in regards to like outlining the shape itself. If you're working on something more interior, it's totally fine if you want to change the brush size to something a little smaller. Just keep in mind that the line work is pretty important for the outcome. Just a helpful tip for the new user in Procreate. If you're trying to make a perfectly straight line, all you have to do is at the very end of that line, just keep your pen down for a second or two and it'll automatically straighten it for you. This will also apply to like rounded lines. This is going to help to avoid that jagged effect unless you're going for something a bit more imperfect, which is totally cool. Okay, remember, working with the lines is supposed to be like another rough draft, but if you feel pretty solid and you're good to go, you feel like this is it, this is your final line work, then move forward. If you need to create another layer just to get them perfect, like maybe you missed something or you wanted to add something along the way, knock it out. Okay, if you feel good about this, you feel like this is the perfect line work you could possibly do, go ahead and delete or hide the other previous layers. Next, I want you to go ahead and create a new layer and drop it right below the line layer. This is going to be your color layer. Okay, I mean, you're at the fun part now. Just pick the brush you feel most comfortable using and get to work coloring within the lines. I mean, it's not, you know, it's not rocket science when it comes to coloring your artwork, but There is a couple of things to notate. There are some odd sorts out there that do use light mode for their chat, so it's a white background. So make sure you're not using super light tones. Same thing for the dark mode. Make sure you have some sort of vibrant color that's going to pop well against a dark background, unless you're going for it to blend in with some sort of creative approach to it. Another note for coloring your artwork, make sure that all the colors you use clash well enough with each other. For example, if you're using a blue and then right next to it, you want to use a different blue, but it's not very far from each other on the color spectrum, it's gonna look pretty much the exact same when you shrink this emote down to submit. So make sure it's just far enough away to where you can tell that is a different color. Okay, if you've gotten to the point where you feel pretty comfortable with your color work, the next step would be adding like a shading layer. So if you wanted to go ahead and do that, add a new layer, title it shading, and just put it right in between the line layer and the color layer. That way it overlaps your color, but not your line work. Okay, there's really not much to shading your artwork. And to keep it really simple, just consider where your light source is coming from and then apply shadows to where you think it might be. The simple way to do this is get your pin drop tool, match the color, and then just darken that color to whatever tone that will clash well with the original color. So just make the color darker. And then just go in and add a subtle bit of shading and see how it looks. This also applies to lighting. So if you want to go in and add lighter tones to certain areas that you feel should be brighter to pop a bit more, by all means, go ahead. Don't overcomplicate this. I know you're probably wanting to do more of that airbrush shading technique or the gradual changing color tone, which can be covered in another tutorial video. Keep in mind that there are emote artists out there that add their own shading technique, but I think it's more of a selling point at a larger format. But when you shrink it down to size, you can barely tell these subtle changes in color tone. Okay, it might have seemed like a fair amount of time to explain how to make a Twitch emote, but at the end of the day, you now just have three layers. You got your color, you got your shading, and you got your line work. Combine those three layers, hide your background layer, and export this file as a PNG. You can export this file on the same canvas dimensions. When you upload it to Twitch, it will auto scale it for you now, which is a great feature and it looks great. If you'd rather export it in three separate file sizes that Twitch requires, you can do that as well. So the main reason I wanted to make this tutorial video was to give you the confidence to make your own content. It doesn't have to be just in regards to a Twitch emote, but just in general. I would say moving forward, just know that whatever you're going to create on your own is going to take some time and there's always going to be a learning curve, but it doesn't mean you shouldn't try. Give it your best effort and don't be discouraged, because at the end of the day, you know there are those professionals out there that can help you out. So reach out to them and they will take care of you and also your bank account. Okay, just one more thing, because apparently I still have your attention. Yes, I am a live streamer on Twitch, just like the rest of the world and their mom, but I would love to meet you, so come on by, hang out at twitch.tv/stah92. I will see you there. And just remember, you do you, boo-boo.